Hi, this is my TOK essay breakdown series for May 2024. In these videos, I'll be unpacking the key terms and ideas from the title, as well as looking at the question through the lens of two AOKs. For a much more detailed analysis, examples, and ideas for how to approach this title using different AOKs and other TOK concepts, do check out the full written guide link in the description. Okay, so we'll be looking at title two, which is how can we reconcile the opposing demands for specialization and generalization in the production of knowledge? And for this one, you have to talk about mathematics and one other AOK. Let's begin with some key terms. So you definitely need to mention specialization and generalization. So we'll start by defining specialization as taking more of an in-depth study of a specific subject or domain. And whereas generalization is where you take a broader approach, so maybe covering a greater range of topics and incorporating a wider perspective in knowledge production. Okay, and some points I would consider when answering this question. First of all, you need to think about the dual values of generalization and specialization, okay, and how they're distinct from one another. Also discuss how the integration of specialist and generalist approaches might be more beneficial for knowledge production than either of these two in isolation. Okay, and you can also consider some models or frameworks that enable such integration. Also, don't go too crazy with emphasizing the importance of interdisciplinary collaboration, because whilst this is one potential solution to reconciling these approaches, it's not necessarily a perfect solution. Okay, so by all means, do talk about interdisciplinary collaboration, but just also be mindful of its challenges and limitations. Okay, let's get into the AOKs. We'll start with mathematics. Introducing this section by linking the title to mathematics, we can say that both specialist and generalist approaches have played a key role in this AOK's development. So on the one hand, specialization can refer to going deeper into topics like algebraic geometry and number theory, whereas generalization is about seeing bigger connections like in mathematical physics. For the claim, we can say that collaboration and idea sharing between specialist and generalist mathematicians is one step that can be taken. And this is one of the main purposes of events like the International Congress of Mathematicians. And these kind of help to foster open-mindedness and cooperation between specialist and generalist mathematicians from a range of different fields. For the counterclaim, however, we can touch on the knowledge framework, elements of scope and perspective, and consider a potential challenge of these type of collaboration. For instance, the differing priorities that mathematicians might have in research direction. So we might use studies into combinatorial game theory as an example here. A specialist in this area might want to delve deeper into a specific game's properties, whereas a generalist might want to examine how these properties relate to broader mathematical problems or other game classes. Bring these ideas together in a mini conclusion, we might say that in order to avoid such issues when reconciling generalization and specialization in mathematics, the scope of the study needs to be clearly defined and agreed upon. Okay, for the second AOK, we'll look at the human sciences. So we'll begin by saying that specialization lets researchers deeply explore topics. So for example, an anthropologist might be focused on the rituals of a specific community, whereas generalization offers a wider perspective and can help in spotting trends and behaviors across different cultures and populations. For the claim, we'll focus on the knowledge framework element of methods and tools. and say that incorporating the methodologies of both specialists and generalists into research is a key way of reconciling these two approaches. To illustrate this point, we can draw from the work of developmental psychologist Yuri Bronfenbrenner on ecological systems theory, and he used both qualitative and quantitative methods to gain both specific and broader insights into human development. For the counterclaim, we can bring up a potential problem with this, and that is differing terminology. So given how diverse the human sciences are, it's probably not a surprise that mixing methodological approaches might cause communication challenges, given that they do have different sets of operational vocabulary. We can see an example of this in the study of mental health, so the DSM, which stands for the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, which is used by professionals, has a very specific criteria for diagnosing mental disorders. And this might be contrasted with a more general public health survey that uses broader language, like asking participants if they feel down or depressed. And such a discrepancy in language might lead to debates between specialists and generalists due to their varied precision and scope in the terminology they use. Bring these ideas together in the mini conclusion, we might say that to avoid this problem, a common terminology should be employed when combining different methodologies and approaches in the human sciences. Okay, so those were just some thoughts on this particular prompt. As I mentioned, for the much more detailed guide, you can check out my website, toklifeline.com, link in the description. And I also provide personal feedback if this is something that interests you. Please do let me know in the comments if there's a specific title you would like me to look at next. And yeah, other than that, many thanks for watching.